وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى I'm going to be starting a series that I will be speaking about a very important topic. A topic that I personally believe is directed for myself first. It's something I'm trying to advise myself بإذنالله الكريم through this series. And then all of you who are watching and listening, inshallah ta'ala. And that is husnul khuluq, having good manners and good etiquettes, upholding good conduct. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely from the bottom of my heart, أن يمن علينا بالأدب الكريم, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows upon each and every one of us good manners. Good manners is what our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was upon. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had good manners. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about our Prophet, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, Muhammad, you are upon, you have great manners, have good manners. You are upon a very high level, a high caliber of manners. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that good manners that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had is from the things that we need to follow him in alayhi salatu wa sallam. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, give us good manners. You are the one who is able to do so. I ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala, أن يهدينا لأحسن الأخلاق لا يهدي لأحسنها إلا هو, to guide us upon good manners. There's no one who can guide us upon good manners except him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأن يصرف عنا سيئها, and oh Allah, remove from us bad manners. لا يصرف عن سيئها إلا هو, no one can remove us, or no one can remove from us bad manners except him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Good manners, good etiquette is a true sign of a person's prosperity and a person's success. If you want to know someone is successful, if you want to know if someone's prosperous, look at his manners. His manners is a inwan, it's a proof, an indication for falahul mar'i, that this person is successful in life. And it is also an indication of the happiness of this person in this world and in the hereafter. وَمَا اسْتُجْلِبَتِ الْخَيْرَاتِ, and you won't truly achieve good بِمِثْلِ الْخُلُقِ الْفَاضِلِ وَالْأَدَبِ الْكَرِيمِ, the way that you could achieve it through good manners and good etiquettes. The khayr that you are looking for, that you want to achieve, the best way to achieve it is have good manners. الدين كله خلق, the whole religion is manners. The whole entire deen is خلق. فمن زاد عليك في الخلق, anyone who beats you, who goes before you and in front of you in good manners, who surpasses you in good manners, زاد عليك في الدين, this person has surpassed you in religion. Always remember that. Anyone who surpasses you in good manners, who is better mannered than you are, holds up to a better code of conduct than you, that person, he has beat you in the religion. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, سُئِلَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam was asked, a question was put to our Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, عَنْ أَكْثَرِ مَا يُدْخِلُ النَّاسَ الْجَنَّةِ, what is the thing that, what is the one thing that a lot of people will go to Jannah because of it? What is the one thing that the majority of the people will enter Jannah for it? What is that one quality, that one trait that because of it a person can enter Jannah? عن أكثر ما يدخل الناس الجنة. The majority of the people, what is the thing that can take them all to Jannah? فقال, the messenger then said, تقوى الله, being conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word تقوى الله means to have تقوى. It is to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's to be scared of Him. It is to do what He told you to do. And it is to stay away from what He told you to stay away from. The first thing that takes the people to Jannah is taqwa Allah Azza wa Jalla. The second characteristics is wa husnul khuluq, good manners, good etiquette. Rawahu Tirmidhi, al-Imam Tirmidhi narrated this in his Sunan, wa hassanahu al-Albani rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Albani graded this to be hasan, this hadith to be hasan. Let's ponder, let's really think about this. Every one of you who's watching, I myself included, it's Jannah that we want. It is Jannah that we are looking for. It is Jahannam we want Allah to distance us from. We want anything that will take us to Jannah, and we want anything that will bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day. That's what we're looking for. Isn't that not the case? The Messenger told us two things in this hadith that could take us to Jannah, that can make us from the inhabitants of Jannah. Are we not going to take it, brothers and sisters? We're not going to take this on board? It is taqwa Allah Azza wa Jalla, having taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second one is husnul khuluq, good manners. Let me give you a statement that will truly expand your horizon, a speech that will truly touch your heart, that will explain to you this hadith, how profound it is. You might think to yourself, the Prophet just said two sentences, taqwa Allah, husnul khuluq. He said something very big. He said a very comprehensive speech in very small words, alayhi salatu wasalam. Ibn al-Qayyim is going to expand on those, that statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, jama'a an-nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wasalam. He said the Prophet combined bayna taqwa Allahi wa husnul khuluq. The Prophet in this hadith combined between taqwa Allahi, the taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jalla, wa husnul khuluq. He combined both of them in this hadith. Stop here. The person who has taqwa, what station does the Qur'an mention for that person? Allah Ta'ala tells us in the Qur'an, tilka al-jannatu allati nurithu min ibadina man kana taqiyya. Jannah is inherited by the people of taqwa. Allah inherits them. It's theirs. Keep it. It's yours. In another ayah, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, in the same surah, He says, وَإِن مِّنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقَضِيًّا ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَنَذَرُ الظَّالِمِينَ فِيهَا جِثِيًّا. Allah tells us here, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that every single person is going to go above Jahannam. يعني the sirat is above Jahannam. And everybody will fall into Jahannam. The only person who's going to be saved from not falling into Jahannam, from not entering Jahannam, is who? ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا, the person who has taqwa. Then taqwa is the thing that saves you from the hellfire, and it is the thing that takes you to Jannah. Next to it was mentioned good manners. That really shows you the power of good manners and how high in Islam it is. That's the first point I want you to ponder. Ibn al-Qayyim says, جَمَعَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the messenger combined, بَيْنَ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ, being conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ, and good manners. That's point number one, underline that. The second thing he said, لِأَنَّ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ تُصْلِحُ مَا بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّهِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ يُصْلِحُ مَا بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ خَلْقِهِ. The reason why these two are combined and they were mentioned next to each other is because having taqwa is having a good relationship with Allah Azza wa Jalla. When you have taqwa, you have a strong bond and a strong relationship with Allah Azza wa Jalla. And when you have good manners, you have good relationship with the creation. So one is the bond and the relationship with Allah, and the second one is a bond and a relationship with the creation. Ibn al-Qayyim goes on to say, فَتَقْوَى اللَّهِ تُوجِبُ لَهُ مَحَبَّةَ اللَّهِ. The taqwa, by coming with taqwa, it will bring about for you the love of Allah. Allah will love you subhanahu wa ta'ala. By coming with taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to love you. وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ يَدْعُو إِلَى مَحَبَّتِهِ. Good manners, what does it do? It calls onto the love of Allah. It also brings about for you, brothers and sisters, the love of the creation. The creation will love you. It calls onto the loving of the creation. The people, when they meet you, they will love you because of your good manners, your good conduct with them, the way you dealt with them, the way you were towards them. And the taqwa, it builds a good relationship between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I'm saying this topic is very big. It touches us all. It's a very powerful topic. The second hadith I want to share with you, inshallah ta'ala, regarding good manners in Islam, how important it is. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَحَبِّكُمْ إِلَيَّ وَأَقْرَبِكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَاسِنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا أَحَاسِنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in this hadith, hadith of Jabir, it's found in Sunan al-Tirmidhi, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَحَبِّكُمْ إِلَيَّ, the one that is most beloved to me, وَأَقْرَبِكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, and the one that is closest to me the day of judgment, the one that is most beloved to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the one that is closest to the Prophet the day of judgment is who? Ahasinakum akhlaqa, the one that has the best manners, the person who has the best etiquettes, the best manners, the best akhlaq, is the most beloved person to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and is the one that is most closest to the Prophet Yawmul Qiyamah. Every single time your manners increases and it grows and it gets better and better and better and greater and greater and better, even higher, 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 you are more closer to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. In what? In love. Yani the Prophet loves you and you're going to be close to him Yawmul Qiyamah, the day of judgment. And every time your manners goes bad and bad and bad, remember you are distant from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Yani, you're going to be far from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. He's going to, the love of the Prophet is going to be distanced from you. And you're going to be distanced from him Yawmul Qiyamah as well. That's another second hadith that will truly touch every mu'min. يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, who believes in Allah and the Day of Judgment. This is something that's going to make them think. The way that we deal with others, the way that we are towards them. Another hadith. Abi Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrated from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Hurairah said, عَنِ النَّبِيِّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Prophet said, this is the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet said, إِنَّكُمْ لَنْ تَسَعُوا النَّاسَ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَسَعُهُمْ مِنْكُمْ بَسْطَ الْوَجْهِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. رواه البزار. Abu Huraira, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you will not be able to suffice the people in your wealth. You will never have enough money to give to everybody. Every time a person comes up to you to give them money, because money is one of the ways to really bring people's hearts close to you. It is. It's a form of getting people's love and people's attention. Wealth is. The Messenger is saying you won't be able to do that for everybody. Everybody who comes your way, you won't be able to give them money because the people are more than your money. However rich you are in the world, you can't provide for everybody. The richest person in the world cannot provide for every single person so much money. You won't be able to. So, وَلَكِنْ يَسِعُهُمْ. But what you can provide to everybody, what you can give to everybody, وَلَكِنْ يَسِعُهُمْ مِنْكُمْ بَسْطَ الْوَجْهِ. Smiling in the people's faces. وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. And having good manners with the people. You won't be able to provide for everybody and give them wealth. But what you can do is, which is free, is whenever someone comes to you, smile on their face. Whenever somebody, you meet someone, have good manners, good akhlaq with them, in the way that you deal with them. Subhanallah, people remember that. They do, they, it sticks with them. They feel respected and honored from you. People tend to remember that. ولذلك the poet, he said, and this poet here is Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما. He used to say this line of poetry a lot. He would repeat it so many times. The poetry is وَبُنَيَّ إِنَّ الْبِرَّ شَيْءٌ هَيِّنٌ وَجْهٌ طَلِيقٌ وَكَلَامٌ لَيِّنٌ. Abdullah ibn Umar used to say, بُنَيَّ, my brother, my son, my nephew, my niece, إِنَّ الْبِرَّ شَيْءٌ هَيِّنٌ. Good conduct, righteousness, goodness is شَيْءٌ هَيِّنٌ. It's an easy thing. وَجْهٌ طَلِيقٌ. All it is smiling in someone's face. وَكَلَامٌ لَيِّنٌ. And soft word. بُنَيَّ, my son, إِنَّ الْبِرَّ شَيْءٌ هَيِّنٌ. Obedience and goodness and having good conduct with others, being dutiful to others, respectful to your elders, gentle and kind to your youngsters, the younger ones. شَيْءٌ هَيِّنٌ is an easy thing. وَجْهٌ طَلِيقٌ is the smile in their face when you meet them. وَكَلَامٌ لَيِّنٌ and soft words. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, al-akhlaq, al-akhlaq. Manners, manners. Akhlaq is hibatun min Allah. It's a gift. Yes, naam. Good manners is a gift Allah gives, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَفَضُّلٌ مِّنْهُ. It's a virtue Allah bestows. يَهْدِي لِأَحْسَنِهَا مَنْ شَاءَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. Allah guides it to whoever He wills from His creation. This hadith shows us it. Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, that the messenger, he was, إِذَا اسْتَفْتَحَ الصَّلَاةَ كَبَّرَ ثُمَّ قَالَ. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was one, إِذَا اسْتَفْتَحَ الصَّلَاةَ, if he opened the prayer, and he said Allahu Akbar. And the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if he opened the prayer, he would open it with the takbir. إِذَا اسْتَفْتَحَ الصَّلَاةَ كَبَّرَ, he would say Allahu Akbar sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And right after that, the Prophet would say, yani it is from the dua or istiftah, the dua that you make at the opening of your prayer, just before you read Fatiha. One of the duas that the Messenger used to make is, he would say, Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillah. He would say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Inna salati, my prayer. Inna salati, my prayer. وَنُسُكِ, my slaughtering. وَمَحْيَايَ, and my living. وَمَمَاتِ, my death. لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, is for Allah alone. All of that is for Allah alone. No one else do I pray to. No one else do I slaughter to. No one else gives me life and no one takes away my life except Allah Azza wa Jalla. لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, the Lord of the universe. لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ, he has no partners in what he does, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ, and I was commanded exactly that. وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and I am from the believers, those who submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the commandments of Allah, and I am one who stays away from what He told him to stay away from. وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Then the messenger would carry on saying, أَلَّهُمَّ اهْدِنِي, oh Allah guide me. To what? لِأَحْسَنِ الْأَعْمَالِ, oh Allah, guide me to the best of actions. وَأَحْسَنِ الْأَخْلَاقِ, Oh Allah, guide me to the best of manners and etiquettes. لا يهدي لي أحسنها إلا أنت. No one can guide me to the best of manners and the best of etiquettes except you, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقِينِي سَيِّئَ الْأَعْمَالِ Oh Allah, protect from me. Prevent from me evil actions. وَسَيِّئَ الْأَخْلَاقِ And bad manners. لَا يَقِي سَيِّئَهَا إِلَّا أَنْتَ There is no one who can save me and protect me from bad conduct, bad manners, bad etiquettes, except you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Nasa'i rahimahullah narrated that. Just ponder here. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man we know, whilst he was walking on this earth, alayhi salatu wa sallam, all of his shortcomings, and all of it's forgiven. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala clearly and categorically said in the Qur'an to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَرَ Your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven you, Muhammad, for every shortcoming or mistakes. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has no sin on him. He is the best from the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a prophet of Allah. He's a messenger of Allah. He's the final, the seal of all prophets, alayhi salatu wasalam. He is a noble creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah already praised his manners, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ Muhammad, you are upon, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a high level, high caliber of manner. You're on a high level, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With that being said, this is the supplication he would make. He would say to Allah, Oh Allah, guide me to the best of manners. Guide me to the best of actions. No one can guide me to it except you, Oh Allah. Oh Allah, prevent from me, protect from me bad manners and evil actions. There's no one else who can except you. He's the best man, alayhi salatu wasalam. But he's still asking Allah for guidance. He's also still asking Allah for righteous actions, and he's also asking Allah for good manners and good conduct. Where do we stand? That is the question we should ask ourselves. Where do we stand? Where are we? This lecture, again, as I said, it's a two-way thing. It's going both ways. It's you and I discussing it together. There is no one-way discussion. It isn't me talking to you, but it's us discussing it with ourselves. It's me thinking out loud. It's us, inshallah ta'ala, rectifying ourselves. Oh Allah, I ask you sincerely from the bottom of my heart that you give us husnul khuluq, good manners with your creation. Oh Allah, give us good manners and good etiquettes with, number one, with you, oh Allah. And inshallah ta'ala, every single day, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, we'll be releasing a particular good manners that we need to come with from Allah Azza wa Jalla to the creation. Each day, one manners that we need to focus on. Inshallah ta'ala. Again, this series is written, it's prepared, it's for me, number one. I am the one that inshallah ta'ala want to benefit from it, and I want to share it with all of you. Maybe there might be someone who hears these words and it affects them inshallah ta'ala, and it changes their life and the way they think, the way they act, the way they carry themselves. And I may get a share of that reward bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. I may get a share of that good doing of theirs inshallah ta'ala. That is why I want to bi-idhnillahi share it with you all. I've been thinking over this topic too long. Good manners, where is it to be found? Inshallah ta'ala, the khulas and the zubda, I will share it with you all. Another hadith, Ziyad ibn Ilaqata radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrated from his uncle that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Kana al-Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ziyad ibn Ilaqa is narrating from his uncle that his uncle said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to say اللهم أو الله إني أعوذ بك من منكرات الأخلاق والأعمال والأهواء رواه الترمذي The messenger used to seek refuge in Allah from evil behavior, evil conduct, inappropriate speech and actions. Allahumma, he used to say, Inni a'udhu bika min munkarati al-akhlaq. Oh Allah, protect me, safeguard me from evil behavior. Wal a'mali, an evil action. Wal ahwa'i, an evil desires. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yaqulu. The messenger also used to say, these are all the du'as of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And wallahi, if these du'as were not important, Nabiullah Muhammad would not have made it. The du'as are two types. Du'a which is ma'thur, is transmitted to us, that the Prophet said it like this, alayhi salatu wasalam. Those du'a are the best du'as, better than the ones we make for ourselves. The ones that the messenger said, his wordings are better than ours. These are the du'a of the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. He used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min munkarati al-akhlaqi wal-a'mali wal-ahwa. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentions another du'a. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam kana yaqulu, the messenger used to say, Allahumma, oh Allah, ahsanta khalqi, oh Allah, you perfected my form and the way you created me. You perfected it. You created me beautifully. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He created the creation in the best form. Allah says in the Qur'an, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, we created the humans in the best form. And I subhanAllah, I pondered over this verse for a while until I came across a very powerful statement by Ibn Aqil al-Hanbali rahimahullah, where he said that this ayah, that the human has been made in the best form, is a reality without a doubt. And he said the way to understand that is, get any animal out there, the most beautiful animal that you know of. Would you ever want to be that animal? You want to look like that animal? Or are you happy with the way Allah created you? If today, the strongest animal, the most biggest animal, someone was to say, you are going to look like a lion, would you want to look like a lion? And he wouldn't. So a human being has the best form. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma ahsanta khalqi. Oh Allah, you perfected my form and the way I look. Fa ahsin khuluqi. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perfect my manners. Give me good manners. Tawus ibn Kaysan, the student of Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, this is narrated by Ibn Abi Dunya in his kitab Makarimul Akhlaq. I encourage everybody who knows the Arabic language to buy the Mawsu'ah, the encyclopedia of Ibn Abi Dunya. The Mawsu'ah, the encyclopedia of Ibn Abi Dunya. Those books that he has inside there, in his Mawsu'ah, it will leave you with fascination and amazement. The topics that he covers, buy it. In the Mawsu'ah, there is a book in there called Makarimul Akhlaq, Good Manners. He brings a statement of Tawus ibn Kaysan rahimahullah. Tawus ibn Kaysan is the student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. He said, Tawus ibn Kaysan said, inna hadhihi al-akhlaqa, this manners, is what? Mana'ihu yamnahuha Allah. He said, this akhlaq that you see is mana'ihu yamnahuha Allah azza wa jalla man yasha'u min ibadi. It is it's a gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifts it to whoever He wills. And Allah gifts good manners. It is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala bestowing upon you His virtue. يَمْنَحُهَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. He gives it to whoever He wishes from His creation. فَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ, if Allah wills subhanahu wa ta'ala, بِعَبْدٍ خَيْرًا, if Allah wills good for a creation or a slave, مَنَحَهُ مِنْهَا, Allah gives you good manners. مَنَحَهُ مِنْهَا خُلُقًا صَالِحًا, Allah gives that person good manners. Ponder here. Let's think over this. This is a great tabi'i. He's a student of Ibn Abbas. He's from the three generation that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that the virtue is in. Tawus ibn Kaysan, imamun fi tafsir. He's a scholar of tafsir. He's one of the scholars who transmitted to us the views of Ibn Abbas in the Qur'an, the exegesis that he gave on the Qur'an, the commentary Ibn Abbas gave in the Qur'an. Tawus has his own commentary on the Qur'an. Go to the books of tafsir, you'll find it there, inshallah ta'ala. Like tafsir ibn Jarir al-Tabari, and tafsir ibn Abi Hatim, and tafsir ibn Kathir, and tafsir al-Baghawi, and Ibn Atiyya, and others. You'll find it filled up in there. This great imam, look what he said. So his statement has weight in our hearts and minds. He said, this akhlaq that you see in good manners, it is a gift Allah gives it to whoever he wills, from his slaves. If Allah wants good for a slave, if Allah wants good for a person, he gives him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives that person, he bestows upon that person what? Khuluqan saliha. Allah gives you good manners, good etiquettes. In other words, if you see a person who has no good manners, then that means Allah did not want for this person khair. Allah did not want to gift this person, to bestow upon this person his virtue. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى قَسَمَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقَكُمْ كَمَا قَسَمَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَرْزَاقَكُمْ. Bukhari narrated this in his Adab al-Mufrad. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has written for every single person their provision from the day you were born until the day you're going to die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for every single person their provision, what they're going to eat, where they're going to sleep, what they're going to wear. Your rizq has been written for you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, he didn't make all the creation the same in the provision. Naam, some people are wealthy. Allah writ for them that they're going to be wealthy and they're going to have a lot of money. And some people, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, writ for them little wealth. That same way that the rizq was written for everybody and the amount of rizq that they're going to have, Allah also did, he said, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he writ for everybody their manners. The manners was also divided amongst the people. There is a person whose manners is very low, very bad, despicable person. You can't spend a second with this person. The vulgar speech that comes out of their mouth, the way that they carry themselves, the way that they're full of themselves. You cannot spend a lahza, a second with them. And another person, hayyinun, layyinun, yani soft, simple, easy, easygoing, turns a blind eye on things. And it's this person who's well-mannered like that, you tend to see it's not a struggle for them. It's just easy. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writ it for them. Allah gifted it to the people like that. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says in the Qur'an, وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ لِيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيًّا. Allah raised the people from one another. And the people are not all of one level in their provision. You know, there's the economy class, and there's the business, there's the wealthy people at the top, and the middle class. And there's a middle class, there's upper class, there's lower class. I mean, people are classed, right? The same applies to the akhlaq of the people. So we say the one who gives, فَالَّذِي يُعْطِي الْأَرْزَاقَ, the one who gives the provision, هُوَ الَّذِي يُعْطِي الْأَخْلَاقَ, is the one who gives what? Is the one who gives good manners. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ ابْنُ الْقَيِّمِ said something very powerful, رحمه الله. He said, فَإِنَّ الْأَخْلَاقَ مَوَاهِبُ. He said that the akhlaq is a gift. It's a gift. And he said, Allah gives it to who? Whoever he wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim said that, rahimahullahu ta'ala. He said that in his kitab, Al-Furusiyyatul Muhammadiyya, page 499. What I want to say is, brothers and sisters, ولهذا, because of that, what is necessary? Since the good manners is a gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to whoever he wills, It's a virtue Allah bestows upon whoever He wishes. What is requested? What is required from us then? If that's the case, and the Messenger is begging Allah for it, and this is how it is, then what is required from us in order to get good manners? The same way that if we wanted rizq, we would do is two important things. Amrani la budda minhuma. Two things we must do. And these two things are very important. The first thing, inshallah ta'ala, is al-luju ila Allah, that we turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In what? Into making this issue easy for us. We go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We turn back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. We beg Him. We beg Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in giving us this. We rely on Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one is as-sa'yu fi talabihi. We strive in looking for it. We strive in looking for it. We try to look for it. Ya'ali at-takhalluq. We try to adopt these characteristics. When we get angry, we try to stop ourselves. We nurture ourselves. One of the ways to do that is to be with righteous people, people who have good manners. You learn from them. You see the situations that they go through. When they get insulted at, do they respond with an insult or are they calm and collective? Do they stand up and they just leave? How is the way that they carry themselves? If you want to have good manners, you need to do those two things. The first one is turn back to Allah and beg Him, like the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to. The second one is as-sa'y wa mujahadatu an-nafs. Fight with yourself. Look for that good manners in yourself. Struggle with yourself. There are times you want to respond. Teach yourself to restrain yourself, to imprison your nafs, not to give in. Walidhalika is very hard, especially when somebody's not being nice to you. You want to respond, but just let go. Now, this is one of the amazing advices that I heard, which is don't let people who have bad manners influence you and become your teacher in the way that you should deal with situations. Someone's not nice to you, they insult you. You shouldn't let them dictate for you what you should say in response. You should now shine and prove to this person that you are not going to stoop to that level. That you have your own personality. That you have your own unique way of dealing with the situation. And that is not the way that they're dealing with it. So you turn away from it. It's hard. It is not easy when you're in that situation. But it is something we need to fight with and always make sure we achieve. Abi Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, ma min shay'in, there is nothing. Ponder here, the word ma is a nafi, it's a negation. Shay'in is an indefinite. I want you to ponder here. The word ma in Arabic is called a nafiyah. It's a negating thing. It negates. We're saying there isn't. Like negating. And right after it, there is an indefinite word. Yeah, there's two types in the English language. There is an indefinite and there's a definite, right? Like the word, the article the is a, like an it's indefinite word, right? It's a definite word. When you say the tree, and it's mu'arraf, we know what tree you're talking about. The tree, okay. But if you say a tree, it becomes indefinite now. We don't know what tree you're talking about. So the article the and a changes whether it's known or it's unknown. In the Arabic language, there's a type of tanween. Tanween, the tanween's 10 types. One of the types of tanween, the an, in, un, that you study in madrasa. There's a type of tanween called tanween al-tankir. It's called tanween al-tankir. It's an indefinite. It's an indefinite tanween. Look at this hadith. We have an indefinite here word, but before it, there's a negative or a negating term, a negating word. Okay? We have the word which is ma, which is nafiya. It's negating. And right after it, we have an indefinite, which is ma min shay'in. In the Arabic language, there's a principle now. According to scholars of the Arabic language and also the usuliyin, the scholars who discuss usulul fiqh, which is what? If there is a negating term, or if there's a negation, if there's a negation, and right after it is an indefinite, this shows generality. Umum, they call it. That this is general now. It's not specific. It's general. What benefit does this have right now in the hadith? It has a big benefit, which is, ma min shay'in, there is nothing whatsoever, athqalu fil mizani, that is heavy on the scale, min husn al khuluqi, than good manners. So there is nothing, nothing. The hadith is saying nothing. Ponder here, the heaviest thing on the scale of the day of judgment is good manners. That's what the hadith is saying. The heaviest thing, there's nothing heavier than good manners. I want you to think here, how powerful it is. Yani, there is nothing else. The number one, the first thing that's heaviest on the scale, the day of judgment, is husnul khuluq. Abu Dawud narrated this hadith. Tirmidhi narrated a slightly different wording, which is ma min shay'in. Again, the generalization is still there. The generality is still there. Ma min shay'in. There is nothing whatsoever, yudha'u fil mizani, that is placed on the scale, athqalu min husn al khuluqi, then that is heavier than the good manners. Wa inna sahiba husn al khuluqi, and the one who has good manners, la yablughu bihi darajata sahibi as-sawmi was-salati, the person who possesses good manners, the person who possesses good manners, la yablughu, he or she will reach darajata sahibi as-sawmi was-salati, you are going to reach the level of a person who prays a lot and a person who fasts a lot. You are of that level. You are with a person who's praying qiyamul layl, who's fasting Mondays and Thursdays. Yani you're with those people. All because of what? All because you have good manners. Husnul khuluq. Good manners. Wa inna sahiba husnul khuluqi. The person who possesses good manners, has good akhlaq, layablughu bihi darajata sahibi sawmi wa salati. The person will reach the level of a person who prays a lot and a person who fasts a lot. This and the hadith that Imam Abi Dawood, those two wordings, when we bring them together, what comes out of it? What comes out from this is that the scale, the day of judgment, the heaviest thing on that scale, the day of judgment, is having good manners. The day of judgment, your actions are going to be weighed and scaled, Yawmul Qiyamah. You are at that moment in need of everything that can make your scale heavy, because it's your key to Jannah. It's the door to that. It's the key to Jannah. You're standing there, Yawm al-Qiyamah, fi arasati Yawm al-Qiyamah, and your deeds are being weighed in front of you. What you want the most is to have your scale heavy, something to push it down, to make it heavy, so it takes you up into Jannah. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا, the believers who have the most complete iman, yani the person who's complete, his iman is complete, yani iman is kamil. It's not he has iman. No. Iman is categorized into three based on the famous hadith, al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'ba, ama al-imanu bid'un wa sittuna shu'ba. A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah, wa adnaaha imatatu al-adha 'an at-tariq, wal haya'u شعبة من الإيمان. أما والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. Ponder here. The Prophet divided the iman into three. There's asal, a bare minimum that makes you a believer. It just gives you iman to just, you know, you're at the asal, your base. And the hadith also mentions someone who's not only on the, he's actually grown a bit more, he's come with wajibul iman, which is a bit higher. He's come with the obligatory things, and there's the highest level, which is the third one, which is iman, which is kamil, complete. This person has come with the asal, the wajib, and then gone into the sunan and the nawafil, and his iman is complete. The messenger told us in this hadith, what is it that makes a person's iman complete? The messenger said, "Akmal al-mu'minina iman." The person whose iman is complete is ahsanuhum khuluqa. The person who has the best manners, the best etiquettes, the best code of conduct. Wa khayrukum khayrukum linisa'ihim. And the best from amongst you is the one who is the best to their women. To their women. A person's akhlaq is determined by the closest person to you. That's when it becomes more clearer. The hadith, by the way, Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated it, rahimahullah. And this hadith, Abu Hurairah didn't just narrate it from the Prophet alone. Our mother Aisha narrated it with him. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna min akmali al-mu'minina imana ahsanuhum khuluqa wa altafuhum bi ahlihi." And the most, and the last part of the hadith, it says, "Wa altafuhum bi ahlihi." He's gentle to his family. And Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated both of them on the authority of Aisha and also on the authority of Abu Hurairah. Al-Halimiyyu, rahimahullah, he said, "Dalla," this has shown us, this hadith has shown us, "ala anna husna al-khuluq," that good manners, good code of conduct, good etiquettes, is a what? Imanun, it's iman, wa'adamuhu nuqsanu iman, and the absence of good manners and the absence of good etiquettes is the reduction of a person's iman. وَأَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَتَفَاوَتُونَ فِي إِيمَانِهِمْ. And the believers, the mu'minun, their levels in their iman is based upon what? Based on their akhlaq. وَأَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, the believers, يَتَفَاوَتُونَ فِي إِيمَانِهِمْ, the people are not the same in their iman. فَبَعْضُهُمْ, some of them are what? أَكْمَلُ إِيمَانًا, the iman is complete than the rest of the people. وَمِنْ ثَمَّ, and because of that, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَانَ الْمُصْطَفَى sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَحْسَنَ النَّاسِ خُلُقًا. The people's, the iman is like, we're not all the same. Our iman is different. Some are higher than others. So, the question here is, who had the best manners? Nabiullah Muhammad. So his iman is higher than us. How is connected here? وَمِنْ ثَمَّ كَانَ الْمُصْطَفَى أَحْسَنَ النَّاسِ خُلُقًا. And because of that, he said the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the best manners from everybody else. Because his iman is the highest than everybody else. لِكَوْنِ أَكْمَلُهُمْ إِيمَانًا. وَخِيَارُكُمْ خِيَارُكُمْ لِنِسَائِهِمْ. And the best from amongst you is the one that is the best to his spouse, or his partner, his wife. أي مَنْ يُعَامِلُهُنَّ, the one who deals with his spouse, بِالصَّبْرِ, he's patient. عَلَىٰ أَخْلَاقِهِنَّ, their etiquettes and the way they deal with you, you show patience. And endurance, you show that. Well, how do you deal with it? طَلَاقَةِ الْوَجْهِ, smile in their face. وَالْإِحْسَانِ, excellence. You overlook their mistakes. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated, and this is found in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, and Bazzar narrated it. Okay? But this is not the wording of Bazzar. Bazzar narrated it in a different wording. I'm going to first mention the wording of Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, and then I'm going to mention the wording of Bazzar. Because we need to know the different wordings so we can take out the gems and the beauty in these ahadiths. Abu Hurairah said, and this is found in Ahmad and Bazzar, but the wording is slightly different. Ahmad narrated this wording, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ صَالِحَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I was sent out. إِنَّمَا, again the word إِنَّمَا in adawat al-hasr. I wasn't sent out for nothing except, that's what it means. The word إِنَّمَا, that's what it means. It means I was not sent out for anything else. The only thing I was sent out for was لِأُتَمِّمَ صَالِحَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was sent out, I was brought out To do what? To perfect, to complete صالح الأخلاق, good manners and good conduct. Bazaar's wording is إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ, which is roughly the same. I was sent out for no other reason except to perfect people's code of conduct, their manners and their etiquettes and the way they carry themselves, the way they talk, the way they act. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent Nabiullah Muhammad to call the people to what? إلى مكارم الأخلاق, to good manners. ومحاسن الأعمال, and to call the people to excellent actions. And to warn them from what, brothers and sisters? It is to warn them from what? سيء الأخلاق, bad manners, عليه الصلاة والسلام, and bad actions. And the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he called to good manners verbally. He verbally, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verbally he called the people to good manners. And he called the people to good actions physically, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There, inshallah ta'ala, we've already mentioned so many ahadiths where the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verbally urges the people to come with what? Good manners, good code of conduct, carry yourselves well, behave in a nice way. Honey, we've just taken some of those ahadiths. And in terms of actions, then the ayah وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ shows us how Allah praised the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's code of conduct, that his actions is of high level. So that means we need to follow him. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. In the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is what? It's a high example. عليه الصلاة والسلام. سعد بن هشام بن عامر, he said, أتيت عائشة, I came to Aisha. فقلت, I said to her, Ya Umm al-Mu'minina, the mother of the believers, أخبريني, tell me, بخلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, tell me the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم's manners, tell me the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's etiquettes, how was it like? What did Aisha say? This is the Prophet's, the closest person to him, his wife. What did she say? قالت, كان خلقه القرآن. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم's manners and his etiquettes was the Qur'an. Then Aisha went on to say, أَمَا تَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنَ? Do you not read the Qur'an? قَوْلَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. The statement of Allah, have you not read it? Where Allah said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And Imam Ahmad narrated this in his Musnad. Have you not read this verse? She said to the Sa'ad ibn Hisham ibn Amirin. Aisha said to him, have you not read the Qur'an where Allah says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ? What does it mean that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his manners and his etiquette was the Qur'an? What does that actually mean? Ibn Kathir is going to explain it to us. When the ayah in Surah Al-Qalam, the fourth ayah, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, when it came to it, Ibn Kathir commented on it. By the way, as a side point, some people, they fall short in this explanation of وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ and the hadith of Aisha. They say that the Prophet is the walking Qur'an. And this is something we should avoid saying, because the Messenger is created and the Qur'an isn't created. So if you say that the Prophet is the walking Qur'an, even though you don't intend it, and I know the person doesn't mean it, but it can give the impression that you're saying that the Qur'an is created. It could lead to that. The Qur'an is a characteristics of Allah, and Allah's characteristics are not created. Sifatul kalam is the characteristics of speech. And the speech of Allah is not created. An early group became misguided on that. The Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila and their likes. Okay? So just say what Aisha said, which is that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's manners is the Qur'an. Alayhi salatu wa salam. Ibn Kathir is going to expand on this for us even more. How could someone's manners be the Qur'an? Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he says, وَمَعْنَى هَذَا, the meaning of this, أَنَّهُ عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَسَلَامُ, that the Messenger عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَسَلَامُ صَارَ امْتِثَالُ الْقُرْآنِ أَمْرًا وَنَهْيًا سَجِيَّةً لَهُ وَخُلُقًا طَبَّعَهُ. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the commandments that we find in the Qur'an and the prohibitions that we find in the Qur'an have become natural to him. Whatever the Qur'an tells him to do, it's natural for him. He does it without, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, finding any hardship in it, alayhi salatu wa sallam. Staying away from what the Qur'an told him to stay away from, it was easy for him, alayhi salatu wa sallam. It became what? Sajiyatan. It became part of him. became natural for him. ولذلك, that's what is meant by it. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. From the things that he took from it is min al-haya'i, shyness. And the Prophet was very shy. We're going to touch on that, inshallah. Al-karam, how generous he was, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wal-shaja'a, how brave he was, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wal-safhu wal-hilm, how he was an example in forgiving and forgetting. Forgiving someone. Hilm, forbearance. And if someone's harming him, just forbearance. وَكُلِّ خُلُقٍ جَمِيلٍ وَكُلِّ خُلُقٍ جَمِيلٍ. Every good manners he was, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, forefront. I mean, scholars, they weaken this, the Aimatul Hadith and the Muhaddithun, but it's worth mentioning, even though in the Kutubu Sirah, they mention it. And in Sirah, we are easier, as Ahmed ibn Hanbal rahimahullah mentioned, we're not very tough on the narrations. They're very lean, as long as it doesn't go against fundamental issues of the religion, or it doesn't go against authentic narrations. We're a bit lean on the weak narrations of the seerah. We're lenient, as long as it doesn't go against the evidences that are established in the religion. From that which is mentioned is that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came into Mecca, alayhi salatu wa sallam, and this is the conquest of Mecca, 10 years ago, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken away from Mecca, his own land. Allah gave him now the strength. The 9th year of the Hijriyah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Mecca. The conquest of Mecca, with force, with power, with strength, alayhi salatu wa sallam. And now that he's back, he said to the people, مَاذَا تَظُنُّونَ, what do you think, minni al-yawma, what do you think of me today? What do you assume that I'm going to do to you today? When he took over Mecca. Then they said to him, the people of Mecca, أَخٌ كَرِيمٌ وَابْنُ أَخٍ كَرِيمٌ. You are a very generous, kind brother. From a generous, kind brother. And you, Muhammad, are a very generous and kind brother. And your father was the same. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, اِذْهَبُوا فَأَنْتُمُ الطُّلَقَىٰ. Go, you are all free. Think, today he has the power, the upper hand. He is now coming to Mecca with force. He was hiding when he was running away from Mecca. His belongings, his wealth, his time, everything has been taken from him. He left Mecca as an old person, 53 years of age. He left at an old age, alayhi salatu wasalam. But he was qawi, strong. He wasn't feeble and weak, salawatullahi wasalam alayhi. But 53, be taken out of your own city that you've been in for 53 years of your life. Now that you've come back, what would you do? And the people who took you from it, some of them are present and they're alive. What would you do? How would you possibly respond? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اِذْهَبُوا فَأَنْتُمُ الطُّلَقَىٰ. Go, you're all free. I'm not going to blame any one of you. So this shows us how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had hilm, forbearance. And whatever was done to him, he overlooked it. Because he felt, alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was about the mission. Alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, and shaytan and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like, and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.